Welcome to the 2017 Orchestra Concerto Concert. Tonight we have a variety of musical pieces to perform for you, starting with Amadeus. Named after composer Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, this piece is based on themes from his 25th symphony. Unfortunately, Mozart only lived to be 35, but in that time he composed many works starting at early as 5 years old. We hope you enjoy Amadeus.
Thank you.
Our next piece is a spirited, syncopated tune that switches the melody between different sections of the orchestra. It truly gives the feeling of being right on the edge of discovering something previously unknown, a revelation. Written by Alexander Safford, here's Revelation's End.
Thank you. Up next is a piece by an incredibly prolific composer, Johann Sebastian Bach. Originally written for organ, this piece is arranged to spread the work on multiple manuals and pedals between violin, violas, cello, and basses. One theme begins in the violin and the rest of the orchestra continues it. Please listen for the theme as we play this excerpt from Bach's Fugue in G minor, The Great.
Inspired by ancient chants like Warlock, Van Williams, and Holst, A Knight's Quest captures the medieval spirit with a contemporary sound. Legends, myths, and history paints a romanticized picture of the knight in shining armor. Knights are a symbol of honor, chivalry, and valor, and this piece presents one on a journey. Enjoy a final piece.
Thank you. Little is known about the first piece we are about to play. It is of Polish origin, but the composer chose to remain anonymous. Translated to Symphony About Birth, the work has religious origins. Tonight we will play two contrasting movements from Joel Onyx's edited version of this Polish tune, Symphonia de Nabitate. This piece features Anya Nygaard, Riley Wilker, Tara Holt, and Jordan Wilker.
Thank you.
Tchaikovsky's March Slav exemplifies the spirit of the 19th century nationalism as it is growing in Europe. It was written for a concert given for wounded Russian soldiers and includes regional folk melodies as well as the Imperial Russian national anthem, God Save the Tsar. Please enjoy March Slav.
Thank you. again for coming to our concert this evening. At this time, it is my pleasure to welcome our first concerto winner of the evening to the stage, Quinn Wilson, to be performing the first movement of Carl Stamitz's concerto in D major for viola and orchestra. Please welcome Quinn to the stage.
Thank you. String choir performed the companion to this piece, as these fugues by Bach are often performed together. This fugue is in the same key with the beginning theme in the violins, and that is then passed through the orchestra. Please enjoy this arrangement of Bach's Fugue in G Minor, The Little. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. The four Chinese folk songs we are about to play each have a unique story to them, representing bits and pieces of Chinese stories. The first, Lan Hua Hua, tells the story of a country girl who escapes from a forced marriage to a rich family and flees to her lover. Second, Driving the Mule Team portrays a young girl searching for her boyfriend among a team of mule drivers passing by. The third, Jasmine Flower, is a popular in China and abroad as well. And lyrics to this are sung and they translate to the following. Jasmine Flower, such a beautiful flower. Her sweet scent overwhelms all others in the garden. I want to pluck her for myself, but I am afraid of the gardener's keeper. Jasmine Flower, such a beautiful flower. She is as white as snow when she is blooming. I want to pluck her for myself, but I am afraid of gossips around. Jasmine Flower, such a beautiful flower. Her looks surpass all others in the garden. I want to pluck her for myself, but I am afraid she won't bloom in the year to come. In the final folk song, A Horse Herd's Mountain Song, a horse herd sings about the mundane occurrences of daily life. Horses needing grass to feed, and the grass needing the morning dew to grow. Please enjoy these Chinese folk songs.
Thank you. Thank you.
Commissioned by the Chattahoochee High School Orchestra in Alpharetta, Georgia, this piece is named in honor of this town several miles north of the Atlanta metropolitan area. The town can trace its history back to 1830s, when the area was undergoing resettlement of the Cherokee Indian Nation. The name came from the Greek alpha, meaning first, retta, meaning town. The piece itself is very unique, with changing meters and accidentals causing a bit of chaotic feel, which resolves in the end. Please enjoy our final piece of the evening, Alpharetta.
Thank you.
before we go tonight, I just would like to bring forward Jason and Quinn, just real quick to acknowledge them one more time for their fantastic work. They both played amazing.